Welcome everyone to the second episode of the Microsoft Center in the Field series. We definitely want to thank you for all the great feedback and perspective during the first video. My name is Christopher Munoz, and with me today, I have my great colleague, Javier. Hey, Javier.
Hey, Chris. Yes, and today is our second episode, and we have invited our colleague, Yaniv Shasha, to talk to us about a new solution that was recently released. It's called Microsoft Sentinel Training Lab. Welcome, Yaniv.
Hey, Javier. Hey, Chris. Thanks for having me, and I'm very excited to be here on this show.
So, Yaniv, what is this Microsoft Sentinel Training Lab? Like, can you tell us more about this new solution and what's the scope behind this solution?
Of course. So as the name suggested, this is a new solution that will help a Sentinel customer to learn about the product itself.
Okay, Yaniv, but I mean, we have already different methods for people to learn, right? Like Sentinel Ninja Training. We also have like the Sentinel Focus modules in Microsoft Learn. What makes this different?
Yeah, I agree. And those are awesome resources. But we are talking here about hands-on learning. And what is more important is that customer will not need to deploy additional resources like a VM, storage account to generate event, basically to feed Sentinel. Everything is deployed with the solution itself.
Okay. Tell us more.
So the solution comes with pre-recorded data, and we will show during the demo how we basically ingested the data. So as soon as you finish the deployment of the solution, you will have on the Sentinel workspace that's already there, the data with a pop-up incidents that is created for you, and you can just start triaging and start investigate and do many more fantastic stuff with the data.
This sounds fantastic, Yaniv. You know, we talked about the pre-recorded data, we talked about the incident, we talked about the way that, you know, anyone that's interested in trying out Microsoft Sentinel, they can really get a hands-on feel for the product. Now, I do have a question. What do users need to have in place in order to get going with this new solution?
So as simple as Azure subscription and, of course, a Sentinel workspace. And the workspace can be brand new, like customer can create the workspace and enable Sentinel only for this solution, or they can use pre-existing workspace. And it's important that we don't have any additional license required for this lab.
Very cool. And I mean, once I have the environment and the solution deployed, do I just go in there on my own and I start playing around, or there's more guidance and structure to the way I'm going to learn?
So you can, and both optional are possible. In case of the user, if you want like a more structured way how to consume the data, we have created a training guide that currently is stored in GitHub that provides step-by-step instructions on how to navigate the different features in Sentinel. And our recommendation will be use this guide as much as you can, because it helps, you know, it address better of the data and help you delve over the Sentinel feature and enjoy it the best. But again, it's not mandatory. A customer can use it without the guide itself.
I mean, it's so awesome. I mean, we talked about, again, incidents, pre-recorded data. You get a hands-on feel. You get guidance. Now, I have one more question for you. Can we finally see a demo of this great solution?
Yes. Okay, so in this demo, I will show you two flavors of this lab. First of all, a new workspace that user just created. And the experience is basically when user created a new workspace and enable Sentinel, it redirects automatically to our new free trial experience. In our new free trial experience, the user will navigate to this tab, and he can see that the workspace itself with starting date and ending date of the free trial, and he can see the benefit that he's getting on the free trial. So basically, users are getting 10 gigabytes a day, both for Microsoft Sentinel and for log analytics data. And this is perfectly work well for our training lab, because the next step that we tell customer to do if they want to learn about the product is go to our training labs. And this is how you see it in the page. And when they are pressing the go to solution, they are redirected into the Azure Marketplace. with the solution description and the way how to install it. One couple of things that I want to highlight on this description. First of all, you have direct link to our guide, and we will review it shortly, the guide that is stored in GitHub, the step-by-step instruction. But also one important topic is the ingested data and which table are we ingested during the lab. And as you can see, we have a security event underscore CL, the sign-in underscore CL, but I'm used to have security event and office activity. So why I'm seeing underscore CL, guys? Any hint?
I mean, I'm guessing, Yaniv, that is because you probably use the Local Analytics API to ingest data into the workspace. Is that right?
Again, a great answer, Javier. And let me just share that Javier was one of the creator of this environment. So he has like secret knowledge here. Yeah, you are right. We are using API, and API currently is only able to push data to custom logs. So let me go back to the same workspace. And I want to show you a different way to consume this data via the Content Hub. So Content Hub, it's also a new experience to deploy content and also control the life cycle of the solution. So when I press the Content Hub and search here training, I can see directly our training lab. And when I press the training lab tile, I can see the same description here. And we are basically installing the solution itself. We are creating it directly from here. And once we are creating, we are redirected into the deployment experience, the ARM-based deployment. And we are able to see here the artifact that we are going to deploy. We will review it shortly together. And the only option that the user needs to decide here is the resource group and the workspace that you want to deploy it. This is a Sentinel workspaces. So let me select one, for example.
One important point, Yaniv. So do I need to have Sentinel installed in the workspace before I can deploy the solution?
For sure, and we are seeing a user that sometimes doesn't have it. And yeah, we rely on Sentinel feature on the deployment process. Okay. For sure.
One more follow-up question there, Yaniv. What is the cost to run the solution?
So the solution itself is free of cost, of course. And because we have also the free trial itself, because if you are using it on a free data, on a newly created workspace, so also the ingested data will be free for the first 31 days, of course.
Excellent, perfect.
Okay, so let me go with you with the installation packet. So during the deployment, we deploy a workbook, really nice one that will help us to investigate one incident. So you can see the name. You can, of course, change the name here. We are deploying three different analytics rules, and we are not only deploying them, we are also activating them, and you will see that they are generating some cool incident. Also, we have a full model about hunting queries, and this is the hunting queries that we deploy, very cool one with the MITRE tactic integration. One of the investigation will involve watchlist, so another great feature of Sentinel watchlist, and one cool playbook that help us to do enrichment. We are using some GeoIP enrichment, and you will see how we can use this data as part of the investigation. So really a quick deployment process. After we press review and create, the process itself took around 15 minutes to complete.
Why 15 minutes, Yaniv?
It's a hard one, Javier. So we are using Log Analytics API to ingest the pre-recorded data. We mentioned it. Sometimes we know from our experience that the data itself took between 7 to 10 minutes until the data itself ingested. And we want to wait a bit to run the analytics rule to be able to give the user experience that when you open the workspace, you will see all the incidents already pop up.
Okay. So as a user, I should expect that when I click here, review and create, this will take around 15 minutes. And then after those 15 minutes, everything will be ready in the workspace for me to query, and the alerts will be ready and stuff like that, right?
Exactly. And let me show you how it looks on the other side. So this is like a different workspace that I just finished the deployment past the 15 minutes. And in the overview page, you can see all the events that we already ingested, 24K events, and the type of the event and the table. You see the CL that we just mentioned. In the right side, you see the three incidents, the corresponding incident for the three analytics rule that we just ingested. And let me take you to one incident to show you how it looked like. So if I will open the incident, you will see, for example, the sign-in with the disabled user account incident with event and entities, the full, rich incident with the data. But I just want to show you how it looks on the guide itself in GitHub. So if I will open our step-by-step guide in our GitHub and we'll go to the right modules. So this is how it looks. This is all the modules of the solution. And as you can see, I'm just hover the handling incident of the sign-in from disabled account. And when I press on it, I can see how I can assign ownership, how I can use workbook to investigate this incident. So full experience that corresponds with the incident, with the data that we are just seeing in the portal.
Quick question for you, Yaniv. I know that module one is definitely the prerequisite. It shows you how to get going with a solution. For the other modules, do they need to be followed in order, or can they bounce around modules?
It's a great comment, Chris. And as you mentioned, only module number one is a hard prerequisite for the solution. But users, if they are like enjoying doing directly hunting, they can jump directly after module one to the hunting module. And only do the module that relevant to hunting. So no linear progress there.
Excellent. And Yaniv, how many modules do we have right now in the guide? Can you show us a little bit?
Let me go back. So we have the prerequisite, the module number one, mm-hmm. that as Chris mentioned, this is the requirement. And we have total of 8 modules, but we can share that we have in the oven like more modules that waiting to publish. So currently 8 module with module number one as the prerequisite of the connectors and the TI enable.
Very cool. Yeah, see, like it covers pretty much the main topics that we want to know in Sentinel, right? Like incident management, watch list, threat intelligence, solutions. Yeah,
and indeed, and just to wrap it out. So we are really open for feedbacks and suggestion, and we want, of course, to grow with this lab. So we will post into the description a link to our GitHub to if a user want to share with us ideas, modules, suggestions. So we are really open for feedback and improvement.
Excellent. Thanks again, Yaniv, for joining us today for the second episode of the Microsoft Sentinel in the Field series. We are delighted to have you, you know, part of the call and, you know, show us this great solution. Again, thank you all for tapping in and joining us. And again, thank you for the great perspective that we are getting throughout these different episodes. If you have not subscribed, please feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel and make sure to comment and give us feedback when it comes to this episode. Thanks again.
Thanks a lot, Yaniv.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.